There are four gradational processes: weathering, erosion, mass wasting, and deposition. Very good. And there are four agents of gradation, gradational agents: running water, wind, moving ice, which is glaciers, of course, and waves and currents. We're going to begin with the running water, which is the most important of the gradational agents in terms of what it does to the surface of the planet. Everything that has to do with running water, we call the fluvial processes. This is really derived from the French word fleuve, which is one of the two words for river in French. There's rivière, which of course we get the word river from, and fleuve, which is another word for river. And of course, if you go back far enough, this, you know, brings itself to Latin at some point. But the fluvial processes are about running water and what running water does to the surface of the planet. Water, in terms of running water, is the most important and most effective gradational agent. In other words, it does, for lack of a better term, the most damage on the surface of the planet. Two things make running water an effective gradational agent. The first one is velocity or speed. That means how fast the water is moving. The more rapidly the water flows, the more it's going to be able to degrade and erode the landscape. And conversely, the slower the water moves, the less it's going to be able to degrade and erode the landscape. Now, this is tied very closely to slope. Remember, we had slope before with local relief. Slope is the angle of inclination of a landform. In other words, how steep the landform is. The other thing is discharge, which is a fancy word for volume. Therefore, if you increase the discharge, you increase the volume, the running water has a greater ability to degrade and erode the landscape. And if you can combine both of these, velocity and discharge, you can really wear down the landscape. Take a look at this diagram. If we were in a classroom, I would draw this on the board, but we're not. We're online. So, this has to do with velocity, speed, and slope. If you look at the left-hand side, you can see that I've drawn a mountain there that is steep. The blue arrow represents water flowing down the side of that mountain. Then on the right-hand side, you can see there's a gentle slope, and there's water, the blue arrow, going across that gentle slope. Which of these two is likely to have water moving at the greatest velocity? Go ahead, I'll give you a second to think about it. Here, I'll give you a hint. I'm gonna give credit where credit's due. A student in my class gave me this. It's like a roller coaster, okay? If you're on a roller coaster, where's the greatest velocity? Yeah, that's right. So the one on the left-hand side, the steep slope, that's where water's going to be moving the most rapidly. And because of that, what happens is this. In areas with a steep slope, degradational, erosional landforms tend to dominate, whereas in areas with a gentle slope, aggradational, depositional landforms tend to dominate. I used to own a house in Eastern Europe, in the northern part of the Czech Republic, and there was a flood when I was there at one point. A flood is increased discharge. Now, that's not the house that I owned. If you take a look at this bridge when I was escaping from the flood, all of that stuff in the foreground, that's somebody's house or multiple houses, because this is what running water can do when you increase discharge and if you increase velocity also. When you see those people standing on that bridge, and that water's lapping right at the bottom of the bridge, normally that water is 20 feet below that bridge. But during the flood, you can see where it was at. Now, I escaped, and something like 10 days later, I came back, and this is from a different direction, but you can see what happened to the bridge. And this is what happens with running water. Running water can be a very destructive agent on the landscape. Now, I say destructive from a human perspective. This is a natural process that occurs on the landscape. But if it can take out concrete and asphalt and houses, it's obviously going to be able to move dirt around as well. So if you can increase velocity and you can increase discharge, the ability of running water to degrade the landscape significantly increases as well.